Okay, for the terraces, there's some echinacea coming up, taking its time. Blueberry, I don't remember which one that is, I think I can check my notes. Onions, some of them are starting to size up. Our tomatoes, I'm looking really close, these are black plum tomatoes. And I'm super excited about those. We've got flowers, no fruit yet. Nasturtiums, it is mid-ish June. There is this blueberry never flowered, or maybe it had like two or three flowers on it. But what you can do is a burgundy leaf blueberry. It advertises the variety. I don't know if that's an actual variety, but that's what this tag said. My artichoke is actually getting bigger. Sage is coming back from almost nothing, as are kales. And those seem awfully crowded now, and I have to thin that out here with some things. Thyme and borage is all coming back. My yarrow has exploded in blooms, which is awesome. This is a really big pumpkin. And I do this kind of every year, like I don't have enough room to just dedicate to them, so I put them at the edge of the bed and let them take over the yard, and it makes my partner crazy, but you know, we do what we gotta do. Overview, that's all Roma tomatoes, and I believe it's the same Marzano or two. These are all indeterminate tomatoes. And that is squash or garlic and mustard here. Got some birds coming through. So if those are black cherries, I know. And I believe these guys here are green zebras, and almost all of them are
trespassing. Please leave the area. This area is under video surveillance.
That's our car wash across the street, if that sound comes through. Bane of my existence. So almost all of my tomatoes, instead I was trying to do save a liter, and almost all of them did this weird split where I couldn't tell, I don't know if they just, and one of them went into three, and so they're probably just not going to do super great. I don't know if it's like a product I've been putting out too early or what, but the paste tomatoes are all looking really good. We've got an onion flopped over here. And we put in some queen lime zinnias. And they look a little, a little small now, but these turn into monsters over the season, and they just mulch the pathways here. But I did cut some of these back the other day from the terminates. That's a pretty good one, where it just splits, so it doesn't have a single liter, so I'm doing 2 liters on that. This one split into three and got totally crazy. So again, probably not gonna get a ton from those guys. And I might just swap out the weird ones and the funny ones. But yeah, let's see. Fruit on that. And that gorgeous queen lime zinnia, really nice looking one. And we'll just buzz through the rest of the terraces. These guys, I just put out my peppers. That's an eggplant that's getting beat up. Apparently eggplants are really yummy. These are black hollyhocks I planted early in the season. They're finally starting to put some size on them. Artichoke and orange. And these are the piranha peppers back here. Don't know what that is. Don't know if I made notes for these. I hope I did. That's a purple. Purple pepper. And I think that might be another tapuano. We did have only two last year, and they were prolific, the tapuanos, but they were prolific. So there's a bunch happening in this corner. Too much, probably. Eggplant, tapuano, porridge. I do sort of overpack some areas. Partly because you never know what you're gonna have in terms of success. Some things fail pretty quickly. And that is one of my, I think that's a butternut squash. Rosemary, mustard going to seed here. Giant red mustard. Some turnips that are ready to pull, and a couple of carrots that are taken off. All the carrots I overwintered were woody, and I finally pulled them out. They weren't big, but I guess from just the weather shock, I think that was a habanada. Oh man, eating down to nothing. And these pepper plants are delicious to whatever little critters are around here. So we may not have as many peppers as I was hoping. And that was, I think, a paprika, maybe. These are actually pimentos. Well, that might be a pimento too. I had a ton of pimento seedlings. And they're just little sticks now, because they're delicious. And then this last one, that is zinnia, green zinnia. That right there is a Minnesota midget, I believe. A tiny camel, basically. Looks like a watermelon that some sort of messed with. And all these, I need to take these guys out because this was Groundhog's favorite spot. There are a couple like that guy, Paul Flower. There's just a couple of boys here. Dill, Brussels sprouts, dill. Brussels sprouts. I could put some beans in here. Oh, this is a Kajari melon, and it's covered in roly-poly, so apparently they really like the taste of a Kajari melon seedling. And now I know why last year's never went anywhere. Note to self, make those a lot bigger before you put them in the ground. Here is Sugar Baby, or maybe a Lemon Drop, actually. Lemon Drop watermelon. And this is, I believe, a crookneck squash. And my family honestly doesn't eat very much of that, but somebody gave me seeds, and so of course, you know, I had to plant a few. Some parsley. These are a bunch of onions. I do have, oh man. See, Groundhog was coming in here. Once the neck on an onion is broken, that tells it, okay, you're done growing. And so the bulb won't get any bigger. But yeah, because Groundhog was tromping around in here. We'll probably have more than one. There's one, another one that won't get any bigger there, so that stinks. This is, I think, might be one of my pumpkins. Pumpkin or butternut, one of the bigger boys. And some beans that I put in. These are dragon tongue bush beans. That is, I think, a Charleston Gray, mayhaps, watermelon. There's a couple, got a little yellow onion, a little red onion. These guys seem to be doing pretty good growing along, and those were ones I grew from seed. The sets that went all through the winter, orange, looks like maybe a cauliflower, maybe a dragon tongue. Checked all my notes before I came out here. I do not remember what all these things are, and they've lost their little tags. Of course they did. Artichoke looking pretty good. That is, I think, Brussels sprout. And I think that's a Brussels sprout. You can see all the, like, that's probably the worst. That one's definitely a cabbage. And that one's a cabbage, which clearly Groundhog prefers cabbage. This is a crookneck squash, which seems to be doing okay. It's got some fruit on it, but it shouldn't be yellow, so I think it's maybe not that happy. And